What's up everyone, it's giveaway time, so before we get into the video, just a small announcement. On Sunday, the Good Game series starts on Natural 8, and every day I'm giving away 5% of my action in a $1,000 tournament. So you heard it right, I will stream every day from the 12th to the 23rd, that's 12 days in a row, and each day there's a $1,000 tournament, and one of you guys is winning 5% of my action in that. Easy money. All you have to do is create an account on Natural 8 under my affiliate link. There's a link in the description. Just click on that and you're good to go. You don't have to play or anything. I would recommend checking out my free roll that runs every Wednesday. And there's a $122 prize pool in that one, so free money for you. Just create an account, log in once, and you're good to go. If you created an account in the past, then make sure to log in once this month. I don't really want to give the money to somebody that hasn't logged in or played in a year. So just make sure to do that. Once again, only if you use the link in the description, because otherwise I can't find you. When you use that link, you pop up in my affiliate list and I can just credit you the money to your account. And that's what I'm going to do each single day. So yeah, hope you enjoy the sweats. I will be live on Twitch every day. Now we get into the video. Enjoy. All right, easy jam with the 10s, guys. I don't like that he makes it a bit small in 3x here, but for 50 blinds, like, this is the most standard jam of all time. If you think this is a fold, then you're also folding ace-king. So just that you're aware of how bad you are if you consider folding. We get led at 44, so I'm leaving some chips behind. Good luck. You can also, like, he should technically be through a calling with pocket 8s, pocket 9s here and shit. You know, so. Alright. I'm gonna do some small betting on the flop. A lot of checking as well. Now we are checking and calling. Very small bet by him. Feels very much like pocket 9s, that's just gonna check back the river. Or like pocket 6s. So I'm debating raising now. But I don't think I'm gonna do that. Maybe I lead river. Oh. I'm gonna lead river. Just gonna make it 42k and see what happens. I'm pretty sure it's like 6s or something here. Just read poker Lero again, but... you know, we started kind of in a GTO way, bet flop, check turn, but then his turn sizing kind of led me to believe that I should lead river. Holy shit, this is beyond nasty. Okay, he's a regular. Fuck, we shouldn't have led river. Maybe it's a good idea to check before. So he says he has like 5s, which also makes sense with his sizing, right? Dude, I'm max confused what's happening here. But like, why would anybody ever bluff raise here? So I'm just gonna fold. But the sizing is just fucking dumb, obviously. Fuck, man. Should just stick to GTO and not lead. Yeah, we should just not call. Punished Lero for getting out of line. Let's make it 3.5. Yeah, we can make it 52. Your boy packs a simple jump. Yeah, he's going for the jam for info. Oh shit, I'm behind. Jam for info is fucking sick. so dumb. Quality content. So he doesn't have a set or a straight. Yeah, going for another third pot. With this and I almost, I'll just size it up slightly. Because we have the king of clubs, so we block some of the snap folds on the turn. Like king, queen of clubs, king, jack of clubs. Alright, got my flat a7 here. I mean, the same with jacks, last time with kings. Gonna be checking back the flop here. Checks clear check back on the queen 10 deuce, in my opinion. I mean, there's something aside for a range bet here, but just checks is the hand that you want to check. Over here, we just check it down and hope to win. Nice. It's not the worst result here. We're 5th in chips in the marathon now. Damn. What's that squeeze? Super small squeeze. 69,000? How big is that? Okay. Yeah, we can call. Why no diamond in my hand? Come on. We had the money in the high roller finally. Gonna check it back. RIP. Yeah, we're probably losing here. Do we want to turn 5s into a bluff? No. I just accept defeat here. I would add steel and fold to steel to that heart. Yeah, I think that's also just necessary. I can always open that if I want to have a look at it. Okay. If you want to see the creme de la creme, the best hand, well, like just the best hands that happened to me. Place to go. Oh shit, by the way. you can check out my Instagram. Would appreciate if you drop the follow. I need to get to 10k so I can get that swipe up feature. But also there's just some sick content, like the best hand of the week. We had a sick hand against Lex over here. On Sunday, just some funny suckouts, both ends. I post some results. So if you just want to stay up to date overall, like some cool meetings with some German high rollers here, Christian Christner, got the Goose. Appreciate if you drop the follow on Insta as well. You know, I just pick my games, you know, I'm aware of game selection. I don't battle with everyone in tournaments where I'm not going to win. What's the third part? I want to check raise. The hand is strong as King 10, and if he jams, we have to stack off here. 30 blinds deep. Never loving this spot, but you got a call. Good luck. Come on, ace, deuce of clubs, and let me hold. Queens. Still got 20%. Sunrun Lero. Oh, Sunrun Lero, what up? Boo-hoo-hoo. Sick. Sick, 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 sick. Fuck yeah. So we can cheat, 500 bucks. Playing for 6k. As you can see, it's very, very top heavy. And with top heavy, I mean the final table payouts. The overall payouts are not top heavy. They're just normal. All right, this beautiful black background. We're 6 out of 9 after a little bit of a aggressive race. And these are the stacks. It's easy to look at them like this. As you see, we're in the middle. Double up on your chip leader. One short stack, one mid stack. Or like one shortish stack and a couple of mid stacks. How I would classify it right now. He's him being really short and then him being the second shortest stack, and then lots of guys on the mid stack area, and then we have some big stacks over here. Obviously starting with the open with the ace king suited here of 50 blinds. You see the button flat. And the big blind come along. Good flop. I mean, we have a lot of draws. Going to start with the check though. This is a board that connects very well with the tightish button flatting range, which I think he has in this spot. Especially after flatting a little bit quicker, he's not going to have like borderline hands like 9-7 suited too often. Or at least something like 8-6 suited. We turn top pair here. He still has ace 10, ace 6. He still has a bunch of traps. But we mostly want to bet here. Sizing, we can go for multiple sizings. I generally like a big sizing because there's going to be lots of rivers where I just check it. Like a queen 10, king is not even that great, you know. So let's just go with a big bet. We also have to back up from the hearts in case we are behind here. That's still out there. We could go like a little bit small, like 60% to like maybe he finds hero folds now with ace 8. But you never fully know. Generally, I like the idea of going big on the turn because we see a lot of folds in the river by him. But yeah. Okay. You might have folded an ace there. When will you be in Vegas, Bolero? I'm there for 4 days in June. So if you're there, I'll buy you a beer. I'll be mid June to mid July. But I don't know if I can drink all these beers that you guys want to buy me. But I mean, if you see me somewhere, sure. Okay, ace check. Recreational limbs. Really like raising here. Just want to play pot in position. And want to get out these two regulars behind. Actually, I'm going to make it 4x instead of 3.5. I would usually go 3.5x, but I really want to deny like overcalls here. Now we just need to flop well. You know, it's okay. This is... I mean, having the Jack of Diamonds is kind of nice because we block him from having King Jack on Ace Jack of Diamonds, which is the most likely flush draws he has, so he's probably going to fold a lot. So heads up. It sucks. This actually sucks so much. It's super annoying. That's the comeback I like from break. That's the comeback you want to see. Holy shit. Oh, and the under the gun open from the short stack. So this spot is interesting because we have four regulars behind and two recreationals. With Mike behind, I really want to flat here. And with the recreational opening, but here he's a tight recreational opening. This is like, oh my god, this is actually tough. Fucking hell. I want to jam it against him, but with these guys behind, I'm going to flat. Let's see how that works. Maybe someone just gets cool out here. It's okay, board. They don't have a better hand.
Lol, dude.
And we just get to fours. That was not as exciting as I was hoping for. Good luck, guys. Very easy, ISO. Come on. Come on. Let's let this FD continue. Hold. Great flop. No two outer. Oh, that's the reason it's a great flop again. Hits the king, but that king is have. It's making you draw dead. Back up to a million. Nice.
From Brazil with a weird connection. It's Brazilian.
Mike with the min lead. Oh, he pot leads. Oh my god. That's. Oh my fucking god. Snap calls preen and pot donks it. The issue about this spot is that we saw him min lead 10-3 earlier, which makes sets a bit less likely, I would say, in general. He just fucking. Yeah, he min leads. Top two. I think we're gonna call, see a safe turn, and then stack off. But I don't really see how we fold here. But honestly, he doesn't really have that much behind. He can still have like tens and shit, but like, really a snap call preflop. I feel like this is just ace eight so much. I think I'm just gonna jam. Good luck. I don't wanna play a huge pot like this, but I don't really see a way around it. Oh, he flatted queens. Come on, 6-9. Yeah! Oh my god, let's fucking go. Whew. We are definitely not running too bad in this one. Oh my god, he just snap calls queens there preflop and then pot donks it. Whew. Whew. Dude, he's out there, dude. This is F. This is just like now everybody is going crazy. The recreations are gone and now we just have rec battle. Oh my god, the 4-bet jam. With full equity still, yeah? And big fudge in the tank. Big fudge, 100% fold, the best hand there. And ace and off just doubles. What am I watching, man? What am I watching? God. I'm a bit suspicious about the limp, but I'm just gonna jam these three. Because I would have probably called a jam as well. Weird. Ugh, come on. Ugh. Gets the fucking win as well. Not even. Like, we chop this so frequently. Fuck, that's annoying. GG. We finished in third in the end. It's just a bit annoying. Like, that suck. Like, that final hand sucks. I mean, I don't hate the limp call. They succeeded. It's just annoying, you know, that we don't chop it there. I cash for 2000. Decent, I would say. Interesting final table for sure. I think I'm pretty happy with how I played overall, as I said. But yeah, third for 2k after grinding for 12 hours or 11 hours for me, not 10 and a half. The tournament has been running for 12 hours. Yeah, I like it. Interesting FT. Bricked some hands. We cash for 2k. Fuck stars for the poker, for the payout structure. Another strap in a bad direction, but keep at it. Just have to point it out again. It's a good time. See you soon. Peace out.